I just had a revelation how to be in the moment. Now, I was watching a music video, and I realized as I was watching the music video that I wasn't paying attention to all the stuff that they want to center your attention into. Remember, when people make videos, usually they make stuff and they try to capture your attention so that your eyes are going here and going here and going here and paying exact attention to what's going on the screen. And I realized when I was a kid and I would go in the very rare times when I would go into the living room, watch television with the family, because I always stayed in the room playing guitar and music and all that by myself. But when I did go down to the family and watch TV with them, and my mom stayed in her own room too, so it was usually just my dad out there and my brother and my sister. So me and my mom stayed in our rooms. That was a beta. I just realized that, man. But when I did go out there and watch TV, I realized now, as a kid, I wasn't following exactly what was going on the TV. But I realized now that my brother, my sister, and my dad were locked right in, and they were paying exact attention to what was going on the TV and the program. Not me. My whole awareness was totally all around me with the walls and everything. I just realized that just now as I was watching this video. It was a Kelly Clarkson video. It's the first time I've ever seen Kelly Clarkson. Never heard of her before. I think I heard of her, but so the universe funneled me right to her video, so I clicked on it. What I'm learning how to do is instantaneously is follow what feels good. And if it doesn't feel good, drop it instantly. To drop it. I'm learning how to do that quicker and quicker. So I realized when I'm watching this Kelly Clarkson video, my mind was automatically out here. But I could tell that someone who created this video is wanting to create scenes in the video and certain things to attract our attention, to zero in, to get us locked in. I realized that. And that took me back to a memory of my childhood. Wow, whenever I watch TV, I remember now. I never got locked into it. I would be all out here, and every once in a while I'd focus on something. Or if I was watching the TV screen, I would be just looking at it in a daze, in a haze, and everything was a blur. Because I didn't allow myself to get locked in by action and scenes and this, and everything. The camera would zoom in on something. I would see the whole screen as one, the whole picture as one. I wouldn't focus on the eyeballs, I wouldn't focus on the mouth, I wouldn't focus on the movement of something running across the screen. I would not focus on that. In other words, I would not get distracted easily. That's what it comes down to. It's called intentional distraction, to get your eyes locked in on something. I realize my naturally I wouldn't do that as a child. It wouldn't happen. I would just be. It's like being in a movie theater. You start to look around at everybody around you, and their eyes are locked on the screen. They're locked in, man. That's called being locked in prison in a box. They're not able to use their peripheral vision and get balance of everything around them and look around the theater and look at each other. Just because you're at a movie doesn't mean that you have to be locked on the screen, because the health and the healing is right here now amongst each other, just looking at each other. Maybe something might happen on the screen to grab your attention. But you're wanting to look all around, man. You're wanting to look behind you. You're even wanting to wave your hand and say, hey! The society that we've lived in has trained us to get locked in. And we need to break that. Russell out.